going to begin with general integral convergence. We are going to see that integrals also converge because integrals are about functions, and we want to analyze that functions do converge. So integrals, on the other hand, will also converge. Now we are going to assume a situation where we have different functions and a certain space we include them. I want to see the relationship between these functions in respect of convergence. We are saying earlier that Laplace also has a definition for functions which are almost the same, and what we do is that we use measure theory to say that every point in a measurable space where the two functions, all those points where the two functions give different results, have major zero. And when we do that, we say these functions are equal. We saw that yesterday where we say set of all x such that f of x is different from g of x. If you take the major of this set, it will be zero, then you say f is equal to g almost. We have this concept which Laplace does use. They are not actually the same, but we say they are the same almost everywhere. Just like we have a situation also in topology where we say homeomorphism, or we say homotropy. Two functions are homotropic, but they are almost the same if they share certain properties. So we have the same in vex. If they have this property, we say they are almost the same. That means they are almost the same, almost everywhere. But functions actually behave also in terms of convergence. We can also compare functions in terms of convergence. For example, you have a function here on the Euclidean plane. If you want to write function, maybe this is 1, this is half, this is 1/4, and so on and so on. And if you want to write functions such as f of x, f n of x, maybe you want our x raised to power n. And you may have another function, maybe f m of x, maybe you want over m. Or we can even make it different. 2 over m, x raised to power m. These are different functions operating here. We discover that they are not the same. But as far as convergence, function convergence is concerned, they tend to the same limit. You take limit of this, as n approaches infinity, it will be zero. You take limit of this, as m, it will also be, so they will have the same limit. That means you can compare them in terms of function. For example, when in this past one, you put x 1, 2, 3, you put x equal to 1, you know you have 1, isn't it? Put x equal to 2, you have what? Supposing you keep n fixed, isn't it? Or yes, suppose you keep your n fixed. This one also. Let me just do like this so that you will not have problem. Maybe n. Is it there? 1 over n. And this will be what? 2 over m. Simple. So they are not have problem. So I will have m now. Is the order of this 1m is what is 1 over 1m is 2, 1 over 2. City, one of our city, each one of our city will be around here. And over four, one over four, one over four here. So this function, it means as you increase this, you sort of keep going here. Maybe I can change this to maybe 3m. That is one this is obviously 2/3, 3.6, something like that. Somewhere above here. Or above 0.5. The 1m is 2, you have 1/3. 1/3 is somewhere around here. One end is 3, you have 2/9, isn't it? So 2/9 will be 0.2 something. This is somewhere, this is 0.5, somewhere around here. For T. And for 4, it will be somewhere down. So you can see this one. What I want to show is that this one will converge faster, but they are all converging. Ultimately, when you continue with them, they will be tended. They will, as you go, they will all cross here. See? So that means the functions can be compared in terms of components. Yes. So, and that's what the general integral convergence is talking about. And you are not where you have a theorem, which allows us to have a lot of value tools, theorem 6.1. If Fn is a main theorem.
This 6.1, that is section 6 of this. So this is still.
If Fn is mean fundamental sequence of integrable function, and if the indefinite integral of Fn is Dn,
indefinite integral
Fn is Dn, for n equal to 1 to 2, and so that means n runs in 1, 2, it's indefinite. Then V of E is equal to limit over N V N of E. Exists. So this limit exists. And this is what the integral, the theorem is telling us. Now we have these functions like I have shown you before. You have F1, F2. F1, maybe this is F1, this is F2. You have another one. Maybe it was F3. You have one, some functions, isn't it? And we want to say that if the indefinite integral of this is assumed to be Vn, then the limit of V of E over E, because it's E now over E, this is your E now, your space within which you measure this N1, N2, and so on and so on. This is E now, you are set. So over this set, you can have the limit of E, and it's represented by D of E. Now, in the group, we use the general convergence actually inequalities, which I will write now is this the V of D of E minus 1 to K V of E I. What we are doing here is to use the general triangular inequality. So here, E minus BE, because we want to compare these two, will be the same as B of E minus B and of E, plus B and of E, this one has repeated here. Okay, minus summation B and of E, and it has also repeated here, minus B of E. So it means, therefore, now the if you allow K to grow, then you can make this first interval and the third one, okay, you can make them to be arbitrarily small. Is it clear? Because that means this one converges to this, so the difference will be a bit like zero. This one also, the difference will be like zero, actually. And if you also fix n, you can allow this, if you fix n, you can also allow this one to be zero, isn't it? Because B of E is, B of E, the limit of B of E is actually, and if you allow n to grow, this will be the same here. So it will be like zero. So that means, these intervals will all diminish to zero, and therefore, if that is the case, we will be having that V of E will be equal to the limit now. I approaches infinity of some V of I from 1 to k, and for k, sorry, k approaches v of e I, and that's what you want to show, that this limit, v of e, you diminish this, and you diminish this. This one is what was, sorry, it is this one that you mean. So, B and of E, isn't it? B of E will be limit over N, because this one will diminish with this. learning young approaches and results of BM. And that's what we wanted to prove, that the limit of these functions as you take young approach infinity actually exists. And they will all be after one, they will be equal to one function, that's f of s is equal to zero. Because as the point of, they will intersect at this point, this is f of s. At this point, actually f of s is zero. So that is it. Now, it's also the same, what if you have something like this, you have some function like, don't know what is this. At zero. Now, you will discover that because this function is not defined at zero, each one will approach this thing. This one will approach that and you will go on. So they are going to share one limit point which they will not attain, and that is the zero. For example, if you take a function f of x equal to 1 over x, and you are now allowing x to range from minus x and up, and you discover that you will now know that as x approaches 0, it will not be defined. But if you jump 0, it will be defined. Yes, because 1 over 0 is not defined. Isn't it? So by anything minus, from minus here, if you are taking negative value, up to minus 0.9 is defined. 1 over minus 0.9 is defined. 1 over minus 1 over 0.00006, this is also defined. But when you, so that means up to very close to zero is defined, but when it is zero, then it will not be defined. Then, but when you jump to zero now, 1 over 0.0001 is also defined. So it will start. So that is, that's it. The girl of Yam and the new. Of course, Hawaii, the major of the set. Yes, and the series is less than epsilon 1. Epsilon. Meaning that Fn is very close to Fn. And if you take the absolute value, so there are a lot of negative numbers. That you thought you are taking the difference. And you have any small number. Now, Fn is less than epsilon over 2, we know. So, now Vn is, you know, ultimately use Vm, that is the limit of the 2. On the next page, you say Vm. What is Vm? It's the limit of those functions. It is less than or equal to the new, of course, will be less than or equal to this Fm and minus Fn minus, sorry, it's n minus m. Fn minus. Of course, the new also plus Fn. Remember, we had this Fm is less than epsilon over 2. So, what we are doing here, Bn being the limit of this, is less than, what we are using, using triangular, this triangular. Triangular.
Well, if you're not
very careful in the season,
FM will help. FM will help.
FM. So it's like this one is coming. This is like Italian only FM. Comparison with VM. Of course, VM is a limit of FM. But we are using quality quality. But we know that FM itself, we know integral of FM itself. It's also very small, it's less than 0. Like in that case, what will happen is that we'll say this is now, this is going to be less than 42. Epsilon over 2 plus another epsilon. So this is epsilon over 2. This also over 2. So this will be less than 42. And that's what it means, therefore, that now. It means ultimately that integral of Fm over, is it Bm? Bm. The new is less than epsilon over. And therefore, since it is so small, it is a limit of this integral. It converges. As n approaches. So if that is the case, it means therefore, if you, what it means is that this one will, since this one, because this is the, we get this from here, then you go back to this, you say Fn minus Fm, because it's from here you get the Bn, isn't it? It's actually, and you say Bn is very small, as n tends to infinity, so you say the limit of this is actually this one will tend to zero as n tends to infinity. And what we remember that is that since the difference is so small that it tends to zero as n goes to infinity, it means it's like they are the same, isn't it? We are trying to say that Fm is actually the same as Fm. If you approach, they'll have the same limit, and that limit is, they are going to have the same limit as that limit.
Yeah.
So 6.2, we have 6.2. Yes. In the last page, we have another 6.3, which is also similar. If Fn is a sequence of integral function which converges in the mean to F, then Fn converges to F in actually major. So the only difference here, we use the major. Says that if Fn is sequence of integral functions which is converges, then Fn converges in major. If Fn is a sequence of integral function, which converges in the mean, which converges. Then maybe to Bn, okay? Bn, then this Fn also converges in major. So it converges, we have seen convergence in the mean. Meaning, what we mean by convergence in the mean is when we compare functions, different functions, and say this one converges to this. That's what we mean. But we are now trying to see what it means in terms of major. And so we define our EN now in the proof. we define EN to be the set of all X such that FN of X minus F of X in absolute value. Then, in that case, we can now say that Fn minus F d mu is greater than epsilon. Epsilon ratio En. Because we now say we represent our set. This is our set. Remember, our set is our domain now where we pick the values. We can set up on X such that when we compare the difference between Fn and X, yep, we have something close to epsilon. Then it means, therefore, that this sequence is an integral solution. We integrate over E. By integrating this over E means what? We are taking the measure, isn't it, of the difference between. You know, but there are going to be differences F1 minus F, F2 minus F, F3 minus F, F4 minus. We'll collect all the for 1, 2, 3 from. So we pick numbers, these numbers we pick 1, 2, 3, 4, for example. Then we'll now apply them here. F1, F2, and be taken. So it's, we are taking the measure, so it will be greater than epsilon measure of E, because this is going to measure E. But then we know that this EI is, I think it's EI, not just EN. Now, but what is the measure of EM as entered to unity, or EI as?
Measure of
EI.
What is this as? What's the measure as I tends to infinity? You want to?
We saw these sequence, monotonic sequences that that diminish when we say E1, we saw it, E1 is contained, E2 contained, E3 contained, and so on and so forth. So this one is supposed to be getting. Oh, okay, that's how we are. Sorry. E plus 1 contained in E. So that means this one will keep diminishing. For example, if you have a E10 will be smaller than E9. E9 will be smaller than E8. So if you keep diminishing, just like you have these intervals, maybe this is your, the biggest one, maybe this is your E1. Okay, so E2 will be something smaller, E2. E3 will be something smaller, E3. E4 will be something much smaller than E3. You keep, so as you keep, as these numbers go to infinity, this will keep diminishing. After a time, you have no interval, and then you say zero. So that it means, therefore, the measure of this as EI actually will tend to zero. This is that as I tend to infinity. And we say this measure converges now. So we say EI converges, and we say that EI converges. In measure now, not in integration. So here, Fm converges to F's. in the mean, if the mean may be integral. Here, EI converges immediately. So it means convergence in the mean will imply convergence in measure. And so the two are interrelated. And I think that's the last theorem we will take. We are not.